Who's it gonna be? Who's it gonna be? Oh yeah, it is my bitch.
Remember, the ball must travel 10 yards. It's loose. Mud Dogs Football.
I don't care anymore. Whoa. I don't care anymore. Whoa. No more. No more. Hey ho, hey! A little Phil Collins. A little off-key Phil Collins. Yeah, I'm not awake yet, people. I'm actually pretty awake. Here's the deal. Here's the dealio. I was up at 5. Came upstairs, I went to the bathroom. Yeah, my guy, I'll just stay up here and sleep. Fucking, then all the hell broke loose. The wife comes upstairs with the dogs. Assumes I'm trying to... I stayed upstairs not to wake anybody else up, tossing and turning, and yet I get woken up. Was able to fall back asleep. I don't care anymore. So who's my bitch today? Where's my bitch? There's my bitch. There he is. Yeah, the guy who texted me yesterday saying he left a comment. It took 3 minutes before you talked football. Listen, this is my YouTube channel. All right? You don't know what you don't know. Check my videos out. I do more than enough sit down and talk a bunch of shit. I got news for you. There's not much to talk about. What are we talking about? What are we going to talk about? Jalen Hurts struggling? Who? Listen. Again, Rob A. You know. Drew. My guy Drew. It's just a topic. People need to... Drew is cool, but some people get... Wow, yes. I don't care anymore. No more. No more. Whew. It's just a topic. It's okay that when we talk about the Cowboys, it's shit show 365. But when I want to talk about other topics of the day, I did bring up Kelee Ringo looking good in the Eagles secondary. Bradbury's on his way out, though. I told you that. He ain't gone. So, you know. That's why it was good that the Eagles drafted not one, but two defensive backs. And yeah, Joey Shakes. Why am I talking Eagles? Because I talk about football. I live in South Jersey. Joey Shakes. It's my job to know about the Eagles. To know the ins and outs of the birds. Know, you know, keep your friends close and keep your enemies closer, baby. Not that the Eagles fans are my enemies, but you guys get it. NFC East football. Cowboys versus Eagles. I need to know the ins and outs. Wow, that was a big ass. That was a praying mantis. I'm running. Fucking thing was huge. God damn. Anyway. It's my job to know, peeps. It's my job. My job to know. A little thing on the Dallas Cowboys. Dallas Cowboys. Dallas Cowboys. It's a good thing, people. It's a good thing. Last week, it was brought to my attention that Cooper Beebe, Tyler Guyton, Nathan Thomas, the other offensive lineman, were working with the third team. And you go, oh my God, they're failures. They're not good picks, all the trolls. See, I told you. No, third team goes on the other side of the field, on the practice field, on the other field, and they get 100% of the snaps, okay? Whereas Chuma Edoga, the number one left tackle, rotates in. That's what you do. You get as many snaps for these young guys as possible, okay? As many snaps as possible. So, that's fine. Now we have the 7 weeks before the training camp. You know, I do like what the NFL is trying to do going forward. I don't know if you guys heard about it. It's called the Ramp Up. It's called the Ramp Up. Ramp Up is, you know, maybe they'll cut down on the OTAs. They're not going to cut down much of the OTAs, but they're going to actually report to camp earlier, which may hurt guys like Micah Parsons, because he don't like anything classroom. My man wants to get paid top pay, but he don't like the X's and O's of it. He just wants to go out and play football. Well, that's part of it, bro. The great ones, they find a way to learn at everything, every day. You got to grow up, Micah. You got to learn to love the classroom part of of football. But the ramp up is going to be get there a couple weeks earlier, or a week earlier, and get in all your strength and conditioning stuff. Because if you notice, when you get into training camp, there's nothing but soft tissue injuries. Guys have been on a yacht. Guys have been vacationing after the OTAs, taking a break. And then they try and ramp it up a couple... Now, you need to ramp it up under Britt Brown and the Dallas Cowboys. So, the NFL is going to try and go to that sort of thing. It's still going to be no contact. But endurance-wise, you're not spending the first week at camp on the side trying to get your wind or whatever it is. You think these guys are ready, but again, everybody, they're human. These kids are human. It's a conflict. You hear Micah Parsons saying he don't want to be at OTAs because he wants to protect his body because he's undersized. Yet, you want to be paid the highest paid non-quarterback. I'm not paying you that, Micah, unless you go out and win a defensive MVP. Do that for me, brother, and win some, and don't fade in the playoffs. Get more than one sack in three playoff games, or whatever it was. Put it in the comments if you know. I love you, Micah, but if you're going to try and reset the market for your position, maybe be the best at your position. I don't know. That's just me. If you want to reset the market, you gotta be the best player hands down. If not, you gotta fall in line, my man. Or you don't have to. You can go play for the Arizona Cardinals, or you can go play for the Carolina Panthers and set the market. Go ahead, bro. Eagles ain't paying you that either. I got news for you. Eagles wouldn't pay Reddick. I mean, I would break the stones of Twiz and all my Eagle guys, but, you know, saying he's not as good as Micah. Reddick, you put up 50 sacks over the last 4 years. So, somewhere around there. Big Sills, that's what he was saying. So, you got to put the numbers up. You want that kind of money, but they want to ramp up before camp. Extend it maybe a week or so. Non-contact. There'll be a lot of rules that you're not allowed to fart too hard, or else you violate the agreement. But yeah, I like that idea. I think that's better for the players as well. So, let me see something. The Falcons and the Eagles have not been levied any penalties. Falcons and the Birds haven't been given any penalties for the tampering of the free agents. I doubt you'll hear anything today, but no penalties as of yet. Maybe next week is what they're looking at now for the penalties. So stay tuned for that. Yes, there will be. You will lose some draft capital going forward. I don't know what that's going to be. If it's going to amount to very much. Who are we kidding? Howie don't need draft picks. He's cooking. Howie vision. And so we don't know. Next week. And the last topic we got to get to today. Oh, lordy, lordy, lordy. Green Bay Packers at the Philadelphia Eagles a Philadelphia Eagle home game in lovely Brazil. Brazil. Yes, Brazil. We got a little problem, people. I don't understand because the damn Brazilian flag is green. So, my thing to you is... I'm spitting. I apologize. My thing to you is... what are these teams going to do? You're not allowed to wear green because of gang violence. You think Roger Goodell gives two shits about gang violence? I would just say, any of my Eagles subscribers, or Green Bay, Sledhead, do not go to Brazil, bro. Sledhead, do not wear your cheese heads and your green jerseys in Brazil. What are they going to do? What are you going to have both teams? What are you going to make it all... I think it would be cool to have the Eagles in, like, all ice, all white. White. Listen to me, Drew. White helmet. Gray grill. Right? Gray. You can't go chrome because it's illegal, even though that would look better. Gray grill. Gray eagle on the side. All white uniforms. Gray numbers. Like... with like white highlights or black highlights. Now that is fire. That's outside the box. Problem is, we're gonna have two teams like that? Or were they gonna have Green Bay wear the gray, all white? And have the Eagles wear all black with a black helmet? In Brazil? It's gonna be 120 out there for crying out loud. What the hell are they gonna do? Hey, Roger Goodell, next time do your homework, my man. Do your homework before you go ahead and send. I didn't like this game in Brazil anyway, Eagle fans. I don't like this game in Brazil anyway. Why? They're too good of teams to be going to Brazil. I'm sorry. Send the Vikings versus the Panthers or something. Why are you sending two playoff teams to Brazil? You're taking away from our fans, right? There's a lot of Green Bay fans, a lot of Eagle fans. The Eagles are losing a freaking home game. Do you finally guess this is the year where you get the extra home game and you can't, the fans don't get to enjoy the home game? You pay these PSLs, these personal seat licenses, for the right to buy a ticket and to get playoff games. And now they're taking a playoff game away from you. But they'll give you a good deal on a rental car in Brazil. Go F yourself. It's stupid. Again, the NFL ticks me off. These owners are greedy, greedy, greedy. These owners are greedy, people. There's no reason we should be in Brazil week one, Green Bay, Philly. I'm a little annoyed at that as a Cowboy fan. Fucking play it at the link. Let's go. That's what it's about. It's about the fans. Anyway, who gives a crap? So what, you got to spend money to go to Brazil? Now you got to worry about wearing your Eagle green or your Packer green. Sledhead, do not go. But anyway, I'm almost at my destination. I got to come up with a title. We threw Micah under the bus. We called the players wussies. And there's going to be gang violence in Brazil. And the Eagles are waiting on the Eagles the penalty for tampering and the Falcons. Can't do all that, so stay tuned for that. I don't know what time I'm going to do my lunchtime chat. Probably a little earlier today. The plan is for me to leave a little early from work today and not work late again. You know, not work and then go to the gym. I didn't make it to the gym yesterday. That's the plan, is for me to get out early. So stay tuned on the lunchtime chat. But make sure you have your bell notifications on, so you'll be alerted as soon as I go live. Which I always try and give you guys a little bit of notice. I'm going to try and do a lunchtime chat. Make no mistake about it. So, that is the deal, people. That is the deal. So, yes, let me know what you think a good solution for the Green Bay-Philly matchup in Brazil. I think it's a shit show. I really do. I think it's an absolute shit show. All right, everybody. All right, that's it for me. Game time, Brian. Otherwise, oh, I didn't do that. Here you go. I got time. Game time, Brian. Otherwise known as the mailman on a Saturday rising grind, sun splashed workday. See you in a little bit. Peace.